Willie Pep, the originator of so many of the different kind of patterns and overall footwork that a lot of combat athletes use today. The L steps, the V steps, the switching of stances, the parallel stance, the directions, the angles, everything you see. Willie Pep is one of the origins of many of the footwork you see today. And even for back then, back in the 40s, back in the 50s, this all-time great and legend in combat sports, if you actually look at his footwork back then, you can translate a lot of what he's doing to be effective even today, which is crazy to think about. He was so far ahead of his time when it comes to this because he was fighting in an era where offense was more emphasized, and he changed the game to complement his lack of knockout power that he was known for. He wasn't known as a big puncher, but he was defensive. No one else in his time was fighting like him. No one else in his time understood his footwork like that. And having amassed 241 total fights in his career and being effective for most of those fights, winning 229 of those fights, it's incredible. Now, when you take a look at his footwork, it's very bouncy, you know. Very rarely will he sit still in front of his opponent, always moving around. He uses the shuffle motion a lot of L steps and V steps to redirect in different kind of angles. And he always is changing his motion, always changing direction and how fast he's moving. So pretty much showing a lot of things at his opponent and giving so many different patterns confuses them. And for his quote unquote lack of punching power, this is a very effective way for him to fight and land some shots on the opponent. Whereas most of the boxers you would see back then are characterized as more of power punchers than anything. A lot of them are looking for those knockouts rather than what you see in more modern boxing where defense is much more emphasized. And he was one of the first ones to take that kind of approach. He threw a lot of feints out there. He would switch a stance so quickly to give another angle on the opponent and use that as a way of retreating as well by shoulder rolling or moving on the outside of punches. And he used that parallel stance better than a lot of fighters out there. Someone that's effective in using that parallel stance to reset his positioning and also give himself that opportunity to move out on different kind of angles, either forward or backward, is someone like Dominic Cruz in MMA. I mean, he is so tricky with that parallel stance. He would jump right into it in front of the opponent, creating some more distance between them. And depending on the reaction of the opponent, he would either move backwards and circle out, or he would move forward, moving toward the same side that he retreated to get in that parallel stance, moves out on that same side, completely tricking the opponent to give himself an open angle on the opponent. By landing a shot on the opponent on that open angle, switch stances, switch back to the parallel stance for another reset to see the reaction of the opponent again. Remember, he's always looking for the reaction of the opponent when he goes to the parallel stance. And then go out on that same angle after the pause. I mean, so many disruptions in that rhythm. And that's just one kind of pattern. I mean, he has so many different things going on. Such a complex game. I mean, that parallel stance of his, he has mastered that stance. And even the elite boxers of today, they are nowhere near effective in using that kind of stance. And actually, it's almost universal that that stance is a no-go. You know, it's not a stance to take in a fight. It leaves too many openings. It's lacking too much defense. But a lot of fighters today do not understand that stance like Willie Pep did and how he utilized it. He utilized it almost as a reset. And from that stance and his natural balancing motion in his footwork, he's able to take on so many angles from there. He can switch stances, southpaw or orthodox, and move forward or back or even diagonally, or he could shuffle side to side using that stance. You can't really do that from any other stance. So there are so many options from there. And he has power in both hands, which will add on the lack of punching power. He was also so good at using a punch and then slipping out on that same side. A technique a lot of modern boxers use today as well. For an example, he'll throw a jab at the opponent, seeing his opponent starting to get a little bit more aggressive, move forward at him, and they would take a bigger step and lean to the left a little bit and throw almost like a jab slash left hook at him. And he'll use that same side of his jab, so the left side, being an orthodox fighter here, he would move and follow his hand pretty much of where it went to get away from the jab and also get an opening on the opponent on their right side. Swing back the right foot for momentum and get him in the stance to face the opponent's right side. And when he does this, he actually gets the opponent into their parallel stance in order for them to face him. Then most likely they're not going to be nearly as technical or as skilled as Willie Pep in that stance. If you're not as technical and skilled as Willie Pep, you're going to be wide open for a shot and land the left hook over the top. This is something that Stipe Miocic, the heavyweight champion of the world in MMA, he does a lot in his fights as well. And I love this moment right here from Willie Pep. So you see here, the opponent has a lower stance, almost ducking at Willie Pep. Pep goes and throws the left hook, but look at his lead foot. His lead foot also moves to the left, very sneaky. The opponent, though, also moves slightly to the left and pumps out a jab, but he gets off the right foot, almost skipping to his left because you see he's trying to also move to the right side of Willie Pep to get an angle on him, create momentum for that right hand of his. But like I said, when Willie Pep moved his left foot to the left, he's also able to generate a little bit more power for that right hand, comes over the top, but the opponent ducks right under it with that skipping motion with his feet. So this is a perfect angle for the opponent on Pep. He slipped a punch, got away from the danger, and now he got an open angle on Willie Pep. But Pep doesn't overextend with that right hand. It just throws it out there almost like it was a jab. Pep gets in that parallel stance, like I said before. This is his reset. He has so many options from here. So when he sees the opponent start to show his right hand, Willie Pep moves back his right foot. That is the option that he took, a defensive stance and direction. By doing so, he actually gets further away from the opponent. And the opponent sees that and sees now, okay, he's out of distance. He pretty much took a step backwards. And Pep fakes a left hook. And look at the opponent. He ducks, puts his hands up. This is the mastery of Willie Pep, even getting put in a semi-dangerous situation. And the plan worked for Pep. What he's trying to do at the end here, he's trying to get the opponent's head upwards so he can land a strike. So what does he do? Sees the opponent's head go down. And now he's in the way of an uppercut. And the opponent knows that. When you duck down, the biggest threat in boxing is that uppercut because it meets you the opposite direction, right? So he goes and fakes an uppercut at the opponent. Doesn't commit with it. Just throws a halfway to get his head to pop up. And look at the footwork of Willie Pep here. He also leans forward almost like he's sprinting out of his position. A lot of momentum that he's going to carry forward. He knew that the opponent would bite on this feint. I mean, to lean forward this much, to go forward at the opponent this much, you have to have so much confidence in your technique here. Because if the opponent did not bite on this, he is so open to any intercepting shot. The opponent leans back a little bit, his hands are dropped, because he just had to move his head up suddenly. It seemed like he didn't think about bringing his hands up as well. He just moved his head up quickly to get away from this uppercut as fast as he could. And Willie Pep switches his feet as he's moving forward, almost hops into a left hook, almost like a gazelle punch, and lands hard on the opponent. Stuns him a little bit. They touch gloves, and then look what you see right afterward. The opponent moves left, moves his right foot behind his left foot, almost in a line, to spring off a little bit more straight at Willie Pep. And he goes and throws a wide left hook. But notice Pep's footwork here. He's almost shuffling to the left, using that parallel stance of his. Just moving to the left as the opponent goes and lunges for that left hook. He just simply redirects and ducks right under the hook. Keeps a wide stance. And the fact that he kept such a wide stance, he's able to get his foot on the outside of the opponent as he comes into Willie Pep. So this gives him the opportunity to move out behind the opponent. And that's what he does. He almost olays him. Excellent footwork here by Willie Pep. So that is Willie Pep, the godfather of footwork in combat sports. One of the first ones that really emphasize on footwork and defense rather than just offense. Absolutely outstanding technique by someone boxing nearly 70 to 60 years ago. I mean, it's absolutely insane to see the level of skill he had back then, even comparing it to some of the footwork today. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and if you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you enjoy my content, make sure to subscribe. I don't normally do these kind of videos, but this one was actually really fun. I like to go back some of the older fights, you know, and learn from some of the things they did back then and see some of the interesting things that you can compare to even today. So if you guys want me to do another video kind of like this, maybe on another fighter or maybe some kind of aspect of combat sports, I can do that as well. Comment that below. In my next video, I'm going to come out with my prediction video for the UFC card coming up this weekend. So be on the lookout for that. So again, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.